The question is, why MapReduce is a programming framework for big data applications? It turns out that several processing steps in giant-scale services are expressible as MapReduce. For example, let's say that you're looking for seat availability for selected dates to selected destinations on different airlines. That can be expressed as a MapReduce computation. Let's say you want to access frequency of the URLs on a website that you've designed. That can be coded up as a MapReduce application. Let's say you want to create word indexes to facilitate document searches on the web. That can be coded up as a MapReduce application. Or let's say that you want to do ranking of pages when a user is doing a search. How to present the search results may depend on the popularity of pages, and that is what is often referred to as page ranking. So if page ranking has to be done for all the documents, that is another application that can be coded up as a MapReduce application. The list goes on. All such examples that I mentioned share some common property. They're embarrassingly parallel, and they're common in giant scale services, and all of them tend to work on big data sets. Therefore, there is plenty of opportunity for taking advantage of the computational resources that are available in a data center. And all such applications need domain expertise in terms of what to do with the data, which is expressible as a map function and a reduce function. And this is the only thing that is required of the domain expert to provide to the programming system, because that is domain expertise that lives with the app developer. So here is another example of how an application may be structured as a MapReduce application. And in this case, I'm showing you a page ranking application. That is, I'm interested in knowing what is the popularity of different URLs that occur in a document corpus. So the key space that is input to this application is a set of URLs. And the key value pair that is coming into each of the mapper is a source URL and the contents of that web page that corresponds to this particular URL. So what this mapper is doing is, in the given page defined by this URL, the contents of which is the input to this mapper, it is looking for different targets. Maybe it is looking for a particular URL target 1, another URL target 2, and so on, target n. And that's what each of these mappers are doing. So the key space that is output from the mapper is unique target names. So the key space that is output from the mapper is unique target URLs. And the value is the URL in which it was actually found. So the corpus of input URLs it is taking and saying, well, in this particular URL, I found this target. If it did, it is emitting that this target was found in a particular URL. And this reducer is going to get all the hits for a particular target that was found in the input corpus of URLs. So all the mappers, they're going to send their results to this reducer if they found in the input SURL the target 1. If they did, they're going to send their result to this reducer. Similarly, if they found target n, each of these mappers are going to send to this reducer that in the input URL, they found this target n. And the job of the reducer is once again aggregation, and you have as many reducers as the number of unique targets you're trying to identify in the input data set, very similar to the previous application that we went over. So the output of the reducer is going to be the specific target that this guy has been asked to accumulate, and a source list, meaning all the source pages in which this particular target was found. So each of these reducers is going to find the number of times a particular URL was found in the input corpus of web pages that came into the system as a whole. For instance, if I wanted to find out how many times my web page appears in the universe of web pages all over the world, we can take the entire corpus of web page available in the universe as input, and the mappers are going to look for occurrence of my web page in each one of those input web pages. And if they find that, They're going to send it to this reducer, and if target one corresponds to my web page, then this reducer is going to say, oh, Kishore's web page was found in this list of source web pages all over the universe. That, in a sense, gives a rank for that particular web page that we're looking at. So we're able to rank the target web pages 1 through N based on the number of source web pages that contain that particular target. And that's what page ranking is all about. So I'm giving you yet another example of how this MapReduce functionality can be applied for an application such as page ranking. All the heavy lifting that needs to be done in terms of instantiating the number of mappers, instantiating the number of reducers, the data movement between the mappers and the reducers, all of those chores are taken care of by the programming environment. All that the domain expert had to do was to write the map and reduce function that is unique to particular specifics of his application. Rest of the heavy lifting is all done by the programming framework.